Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lisa, if you guys are new here, and as you guys can see from the title of this video, I'm doing a huge Aritzia clientele haul. I know it's been a little bit after the clientele, but I was waiting for all of my things to come in. I also returned a couple of things, and I also have a very mini pile of things I might return. I haven't really made up my mind yet, so let's get right into the video. I actually did do quite a big haul. I didn't do the math of how much everything was, but maybe I will actually do that later and leave it for you here, so I have an idea of how much I spent because of the things I also returned. That's why I don't know how much I actually ended up keeping. Anyway, for the sake of this haul, I'm gonna go and order the jumpsuit slash dresses, then I'm gonna go through the tops, and then I'll also go through the pants, and then accessories, and then finally the mini stuff of the items of whether or not I should keep or not keep. So please let me know ASAP. You can help my decision. The other thing I wanted to talk about when it comes to this video is, if you guys have been following me from a very long time ago, this channel actually really started off with a lot of my Aritzia hauls, and then obviously it's been a hot minute since I've done an Aritzia haul. It's honestly because I haven't shopped there in a really long time, and I wanted to share this philosophy with you before we get into the haul, because I actually finally, after so many years of being an Aritzia shopper, I have finally come up with a strategy of shopping at Aritzia. Because if you guys don't know my background, I actually grew up in Vancouver, so Aritzia started in Vancouver. I've been going to the warehouse sales ever since I was little, like since 2005. I've followed every single warehouse location change from their head office all the way to like this one warehouse across from the Starbucks in Gastown, and then all the way to the convention center. I have been their day one fan, and I used to buy all these things from Aritzia, and also just literally like anything and everything. Over the years, especially this year, I think the one thing that really helps me realize how I should shop here is because I recently also did a huge closet clean out. I tried on my entire closet, and I have a huge closet right now on sale at Poshmark, and a bunch of it is Aritzia, so make sure you go check it out if you want some pre-loved pieces. I will leave a link here, and if you use my code getaway, you can actually get $15 off, so you can get free shipping on anything you buy from me. But what I wanted to say about that is because I used to buy anything and everything, and after being able to try on the stuff that I have, I realized that because Aritzia uses, you know, higher quality materials compared to places like Zara, Forever 21, H&M, etc., I realized that, you know, throughout the years, if you are shopping for something trendy versus staple, I actually prefer to get my staple items from Aritzia and my investment pieces from Aritzia, and I try to avoid the more trendy stuff on Aritzia's website, just because I realize that, you know, the quality and the price point definitely matches. So if it's something really trendy and you think you're only gonna wear it once or twice, for me, I actually realized that, do I really need to buy something super high quality or higher quality compared to other places and a higher price mark? Or for the items like summer dresses that I think I'm only gonna wear once or twice, could I buy it at Forever 21? So anyway, I wanted to share this piece of advice because, you know, we're all Aritzia addicts here, and also because I kind of need to explain the haul I'm going to do. It's going to be a lot of neutral colors, just because, once again, following this philosophy, a lot of these pieces I want to keep for much longer, and that's why these pieces are in the color scheme that they are, and you're not gonna see a lot of color. So anyway, without further ado, that was a lot of talking. Let's get right into the haul. So like I said, I am going to start with dresses and jumpsuits. So I actually only got one dress, and it's this dress right here. I actually removed the tag. I don't know what it's called. However, if you do follow me on Instagram, I already got this dress in a light pink. Every time I wear this dress, even in my entire designer bag collection video, someone even asked me where this top is from. It is so flattering, not just in the upper half of your body, but when you're wearing the whole thing, you just look so sophisticated and mature and just put together. So I got that dress initially, and it was full price. I know, it really hurt me. When I saw that it went half price, I didn't buy the nude in half price because I already bought it, but I bought the other color, which was a navy blue. Honestly, having worn the other color, I knew how much wear I was gonna get out of this. And I also know this isn't one of those items from Aritzia. For example, the Ecoumont jumpsuit where you just know it's from Aritzia. Like, I feel like if you buy this, you could wear this for years to come and people are not gonna know that it's from Aritzia necessarily, because it's not like one of those huge, you know, items that everyone buys. I just really, really like it. It's so comfortable and it is such a staple, and I'm definitely biased because I already have the nude color one. So this is the first item that I got. The second item that I got is a jumpsuit. It just looks like this. Oh my God. It just looks like this and it is long. It is basically the Divinity jumpsuit, which the Divinity jumpsuit slash romper, which went viral on TikTok. I could not get my hands on the Divinity jumpsuit slash romper, but I got this one in a different style name, which I will also leave here for you. This is honestly pretty similar. I don't have the Divinity, so I wouldn't know, but I personally really, really love this one. And I also love that I can just wear this and not have to think about both top and bottom. I just really, really like that. I think it's perfect for you going out, going on a walk, whatever. It really gives me like a lot of different personalities. If you follow my Instagram stories, I kind of went through all my personalities with this, including like a ballet teacher. I just love it. It's so comfortable. I highly recommend. The next item that I got is this silk tank top here, and I think it's absolutely perfect for summer, and it's just one of those staple pieces. One of the things I realized when I was doing my closet clean out was that I didn't have enough staple white tank tops. So I wanted to get this for myself. I thought it was gonna be perfect for summer and the summers to come. And it's just simple enough that I don't think people are going to remember this per se. So I just really, really, really like this top. The next item here, it is a more sophisticated top. It's just this little like kind of turtlenecky one. But like I said, I realized for my all white outfits, I needed more white tops. And I think this one is very mature looking, and I feel like it's perfect for, you know, fancier brunch places. Like I said, when I was doing my closet clean out and I was trying on all the items, I actually realized all of the missing style of tops that I needed for my pants. So that's why I went into the Aritzia website with a lot of pieces, key pieces in mind that I knew I needed to match my tops, and this was going to be one of them. This one I just feel like will not go out of style. It is so comfortable. It's just gonna be perfect for all around summer, fall, etc. The next item is literally the same sentiment, but it is this tank top here. This one, I have the tag on still. It is the Benji tank top. It was on for half price, so I could not resist, but it is in this champagne color. It is a silk tank top. Once again, very, very much like a staple, simple piece, just simple spaghetti straps, whatever. This is what I mean by you can't necessarily tell that it's from Aritzia, unlike one of those camisole tank tops. You guys all know what I'm talking about. The one that's sheer and it's a V-neck. We all know that's from Aritzia. Like, I think I was watching this TV show and this actress actually wore it and I'm like, Aritzia. And I just feel like it's not that it's a bad thing. It's more just like over the years, you then know, okay, that's from Aritzia from like 10 years ago. Sometimes you don't want it to be too obvious because then you can't keep it for as long, if you know what I mean. The next item that I have is a black linen shirt, and it's actually from one of their in-house brands and their new brand, Denim Form. So this one, I got it in a size small, and it is the Jane top. And I actually had my eye on this top for a while. I actually wanted the white as well, but I actually realized that I have something very, very similar already. So I ended up returning the white. I kept the black, and I think it is perfect for summer. And it is just, once again, casual enough and simple enough. It can go for a really, really long time. I think this is gonna be perfect for any type of like black shorts or black denim shorts. It's gonna be super easy to pair. So I'm really excited to wear this for my upcoming trips. The next item here is also kind of like a white top, as you guys can see. This one is more sheer. I feel like this is a little bit more trendy than what I'm trying to get into, but I also feel like I haven't seen a lot of people wearing this top, so I feel like I could get away with probably wearing this for many years to come. The piece that I had in mind was actually to kind of wear like a very nice bralette under here. I feel like that would look really, really, really cute. So yeah, just kind of like even a colored bralette or like a champagne colored bralette to go underneath. White pair of pants, I think that would look super, super cute. And this was also, I believe, half price, so I really like it. And this one is the Lucinda top. We are finally over to pants, and the first pair of pants is the Effortless pants. And this one, I actually had already gotten this in a greenish color. I will leave a picture from my Instagram of me wearing it. When I got it in a size 4 because, as you guys know, I have a bigger waist. It was a little bit too big for me, so I went down to a size 2, and now I don't know if this is still too big for me. I don't know why, and I don't know if anyone else has experienced this, but I used to be so good with Aritzia sizing. Like, I used to be so consistent. Now I'm not as consistent anymore. Like, literally one day I will be a size 0 at Aritzia, and like 2 days later I will be a size 4, and I'm like, I don't understand what is happening. It is definitely not my weight, because it'll be like days apart, or like different items, I'll just be different sizes. But the Effortless pants, I got this in the long version, and I think everyone needs this in their closet. There's the black and also the white. However, the white isn't a full white, it's kind of like a cream. So for me, I feel like it's a little bit harder to pair, which is why I didn't get it, or else I actually would get it if it was actually a pure white. For this one, I actually do need my mom to hem it for me, so I will be bringing this back to Vancouver for her to help me. The next pair of pants is also another one that I have had my eye on for a really long time. It is the Melina cropped leather pants. I'm sure you guys already know what this looks like because it is viral everywhere on TikTok, on Instagram, but I am finally hopping on the train. It actually took me a long time to get on board with this pair of pants because I was just like, oh my god, now it's like way too many people are having it, are wearing it, etc. But after I tried it on, I was like, fuck, I see why people are so obsessed with these pairs of pants. But this is exactly what I mean, because I tried it on, so I knew in these pants I was a size 4, and this is exactly what I mean, because just earlier I was like, am I a size 0? Am I a size 2? I don't get it. But this one, I'm for sure a size 4, and I got the crop version because I'm only 5'1". I am very short, so I mean, could be a good thing, because if you are also short, then you should follow my Instagram, because I'm just like a short person dressing up. Anyway, the next pair of pants is basically the Melinas, but in like a cropped biker short version. This is also another trendy item, so I'm not like too proud of myself for getting this, but honestly, I wanted to kind of look badass. This is also in the size 4. They named it a little bit different. It's the Adrian, but this is what it looks like. Kind of looks like a skirt, but it's really a short. Super excited to wear that. Okay, the last item. Technically, I did not get this from Aritzia. I got this at Nordstrom, but I checked Aritzia's website and they do have it, so I'm putting it in this haul just so I can mention these jeans. But like I said, I did not get this at Aritzia. But this is actually the Agold E Riley high rise straight crop. I wanted to include this because I just wanted to talk about it. I know a lot of people are gonna watch this video, so you might as well hear about these jeans. Basically, I got these jeans. They're a pair of straight jeans and they just have the two cutouts in the front. And let me tell you, when I put this on Instagram stories, everyone went cuckoo nuts for them. They were just like, what is it called? What jeans are these? Blah, blah, blah. I don't know. They look really, really flattering. You can size up or down. I went a size down. I am usually a 25. I went to a size 24. This is a very like thicker form of denim. So if you like more like a stretchy denim, I don't know if you'll like these, but if you are very into denim, I highly recommend checking these out because I got a million compliments wearing this in my stories when I was shopping for them. So make sure you check these out. The last two items, once again, going with my staple theme, I got two hats. So I got both a white hat and a black hat, and it is because I actually own a hat from Aritzia from before, and it's a this is what happens when you live downtown. Okay, I feel like I can't even complain because I feel like someone's, you know, going through something, so I'm like, you do your thing. I already wore these, as you can see a little bit of makeup stain on here, but I got a black and white hat because my other hat from them is like a suede camel color, which obviously is super stylish or whatever, or trendy. So I wanted a black or white hat. And also, I don't know if you've been following me on Instagram or not, I've been going off about golf outfits, which is super ironic because I've never been golfing. So I don't know why I'm buying all these outfits, but this white hat was mainly for one of these like golf trips potentially. This black hat mostly just in general, I just feel like I need a black hat. Okay, so now I'm gonna go through the items that I may or may not keep. So the first item going off of my golf theme is this top here. This is the Knox shirt. I feel like it's super cute for golf. I just don't know if I'm gonna keep it because I do feel like it's not as practical as I would like it. Aside from going to the golf course, do I really see myself wearing this shirt? I don't know. This is the only reason why I don't know if I'm gonna keep it. The next one is the weekend short. This is a white pair of shorts. And honestly, I don't know if I want to keep this either because I don't know, every time you wear white shorts, you have to wear nude underwear and it's just like super limiting and I just don't feel as comfortable in it. And I just also don't wanna be in one of those situations where if I cross my legs and you look down, you can see my private parts, you know what I mean? Based on the length of this short, I actually don't know if I'm going to keep this. Finally, I also got this top here, also from Sunday Best. It's just a very, very simple top. It's not that I don't think it's a staple. For what it is, I felt like this wasn't as cheap as I would have liked it. So that's why I don't know if I really, really want to keep this for that reason, because I feel like this is something I can get off of Princess Polly or something. The other thing that I got are these TNA socks. My friend swears by them. Pretty expensive compared to like any of the other socks that I purchased. For $18, I guess I got the discount from Clientele. For 3 pairs, $18, that's $6 a pair. Like, I just remember when I saw my friend wearing these, I was like, oh, so you rich. We out here buying Aritzia socks. All right, like you couldn't just go to H&M or Amazon, but no. You needed like branded TNA socks. She apparently swears that they never ever like rip, break, like whatever. So I was like, okay, while it's Clientele, let's see what it's about. I don't know, if you guys have tried the socks and love them, please let me know and tell me it's not just like a rich person thing or something like that. Anyway, that is the end of my haul. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it's been a while since I've posted an Aritzia haul. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know if I should shop and buy more things at Aritzia for you guys to check out. But anyway, if you guys haven't already, make sure you click subscribe, click the like button, and also follow me on Instagram. And also listen to my podcast while I'm doing all of this. All right, see you guys in the next video. Bye. Thank you.